What's up, everyone? My name is Kim, and someone stole my video. If you're watching this video, chances are you've only subscribed after seeing my morning routine in 2100 video, which I was inspired by Kristen Leo's morning routine in 2050. So I did some research, filmed my own adaptation, and even went on to make a part two. Will there be a part three? Is Rihanna going to release another album?
I could give you a dot, and a dot.
Reggae.
Needless to say, that video is what propelled my channel to where it is now. A few weeks ago, I began receiving comments from people telling me that an Indonesian YouTuber was inspired by my video. And my initial thought was, okay, cool, you know, I must be doing something right to garner that type of response. But then I watched the video. So like any other morning routine, I can't help but start my day by checking social media. I've been really trying to limit my social media use because it just worsens my PTSD. So I make sure to take my pills that are rationed by the government every single morning. Bless universal healthcare. Before I brush my teeth, I'm just gonna quickly grab my delivery from the waterman. This is all we get each day, so I'm gonna set most of it aside for drinking and use a bit of it to brush my teeth. Now I'm gonna go a bit crazy with the dry shampoo and body wipes because you know how it is. I don't even remember the last time I've showered, as embarrassing as that is to say. So it's time for my favorite part of the day, breakfast. All the CO2 has been changing the composition of our fruits and veggies, so resources have greatly depleted. This is why I have to take numerous pills for my health and nutrition. I pretty much gave up wearing makeup these days. I just wear sunscreen. I mean, who am I trying to impress anyway? Most of the population is dead. Please leave a comment, like, and subscribe. Bye! Now, if you submitted that video into Turnitin.com, you wouldn't even get a percentage. It would just say why. Like, why not just add Indonesian subtitles to my video? It would have saved you so much time. Now, let me just be clear, this video is a last resort for me. I did try reaching out to her on three separate occasions, asking her to give me credit in her description. I left a YouTube comment, I sent her an Instagram DM, and I even sent her an email, all of which has since been ignored. Honestly, the last time I was this hurt about being ghosted was when an employer stopped responding to my emails after I had asked them to provide me a travel stipend for an unpaid internship. That's a different topic. I've also seen quite a few comments left from other people on her video asking her to credit me as well. And I just want to say thank you to everyone who's been sticking up for me. If I could bless you all with clear skin and a boo that won't cheat on you, I would. But yeah, this communal ghosting we now share makes me feel closer to you guys. We will be stronger after this, okay? With all that being said, please don't leave any rude or nasty comments. I mean, you wouldn't enjoy being cyberbullied, so why do it? Anyway, what frustrated me most about this entire situation is the hopelessness everyone seemed to have. The YouTube help forum basically told me I couldn't get any help. I considered filing a formal complaint with YouTube, but that entire process didn't seem like a good idea to me, mainly because my private information, such as my full legal name and address, would be shared with this YouTuber. Not to say she'd do anything malevolent with this information, but ever since Jackie Aina got her bank account hacked into, I'd rather not provide this information to a complete stranger. So, does that mean there are no repercussions for plagiarizing a YouTube video? How can a platform built off of other creatives earning $15 billion within the last year off of ads placed on our videos not have any protective measures when it comes to their content creators' ideas? This isn't just some coding homework you can slightly adjust and get away with in your comp sci class. Jimmy can't just cheat off me and a bunch of other people and still become valedictorian in high school, even though he did, but you know what I mean. If it's not acceptable then, it shouldn't be acceptable now. This is why people don't speak up, and it's exactly why some people continue to offend. When there are no consequences, there's a lack of accountability, and then out comes the 45th president of the United States. Basically, we are doing everyone a disservice by not checking the people who wrong us. Earlier this year, Gucci was accused of ripping off Sharon Franklin, a disabled artist. They had dangled the prospect of collaborating with her, but then later ghosted her, choosing someone else to execute this unique jelly concept. This would have been a huge opportunity for Franklin, but instead, this label worth $47.2 billion decided to plagiarize the art she's been working to perfect for the last 10 years. Who do you know in person that does Jell-O art? No one. If it was so easy to come up with ideas, produce content, no one would copy. Our minds are constantly bombarded by a never-ending feed of content, but is it so wrong to ask for credit where credit is due? Clearly, this YouTuber with 2 million subscribers is talented and hardworking, but I have a right to defend my work and I refuse to not be credited for it. This isn't tea, this is just a PSA to respect other people's work. And with that being said, I should probably shout out my ghostwriter.